Dearly beloved, we're gathered together today, Friday, December the 11th, 2015, to unite this couple, Jordan Lee and Haley Decker, in holy matrimony. This is both a solemn and a joyous occasion. It's even happier because we remember the birth of Jesus Christ during this season. Once when Jesus had been praying, his disciples said, "The Lord, teach us to pray." And so he gave a model prayer to the world, which we'll say now that's said by hundreds of millions of people still today. So let us begin this spiritual occasion with a prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. And so, Lord, we pray the prayer of Jesus and add one special request. May the love of Jordan and Haley grow stronger and wiser and more abundant for one another each day for the remainder of their days on this earth. Amen. Love is a word that we use freely and often, but seldom really think about what love really is. There are many famous quotes or sayings, and a few that I think are interesting is, love is like a friendship caught on fire. In the beginning, a flame very pretty, often hot and fierce, but still only light and flickering. As love grows older, our hearts mature and our love becomes as cold, deep burning, unquenchable. It's loyalty through good and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is when the other person's happiness is more important than our own. You don't marry the person you can live with. You marry the person you can't live without. Love me when I least deserve it, because that's when I really need it the most. And let the wife make the husband glad to come home, and let the husband make her sorry to see him leave. But perhaps the best description of love comes from the Bible in the book of Corinthians. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, and it always perseveres. Love never fails. And so we come to the real purpose of this occasion. The exchanges of promises and vows or truths, and the marriage of Jordan Lee and Haley Decker. And this part is even more meaningful because the vows and the words have been carefully and lovingly chosen by Haley and Jordan. Love is the reason we're here. In marriage, we not only say I love you today, but also I promise to love you for all our tomorrows. Jordan and Haley, in the days ahead of you, there will be stormy times and good times, times of conflict and times of joy. I ask you to remember this advice. Never go to bed angry. Let your love be stronger than your anger. Learn the wisdom of compromise, for it's better to bend than to break. Believe the best of your beloved rather than the worst. Confide in your partner and ask for help when you need it. Remember that true friendship is the basis for any lasting relationship. Give your spouse the same courtesies and kindnesses you bestow on your friends. Say, I love you every day. Jordan and Haley, I remind you that marriage is a precious gift, a lifelong commitment, and a challenge to love one another more completely each and every day. So now, if you'll hold your hands and look each other in the eye, Jordan, with this understanding, do you take Haley to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others and to be faithful only to her so long as you both shall live? And Haley, with this understanding, do you take Jordan to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others to be faithful only to him so long as you both shall live. Okay, Colton, you have the rings? You place it on her finger. This ring, an unbroken, never-ending circle, is a symbol of committed, unending love. Jordan, as you place this ring on Haley's finger, repeat these words after me. This ring, a gift for you.
A gift for you.
It symbolizes my desire. That you be my wife.
That you be my wife.
From this day forward. As this ring.
Has no end.
Neither shall my love for you. Okay, Haley, if you'll now place Jordan's ring on. Repeat after me. This ring, a gift for you, symbolizes my desire that you be my husband from this day forward. As this ring has no end, neither shall my love for you. Jordan and Haley, in your journey of life together, remind yourselves often of the love that brought you together. Give the highest priority to your love. When challenges come, remember to focus on what is right between you. In this way, you can ride out the storms. And when clouds hide the sun in your lives, remember, even if you lose sight of it for a moment, the sun is always there. Jordan and Haley, you have consented together in holy matrimony. Before God, you have pledged your vows to each other and have exchanged rings as tokens of your love and commitment to each other. In accordance with the laws of the state of Texas, with the authority of God's word and with great joy, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Lee.
Yeah, they can't walk until you push right button.
This one.
I know.
Haley's not looking.